Hi, I'm Forrest Taylor. I'm a curriculum architect at Red Hat, and today we're going to talk about how to import a CloudForms appliance into Rev. So the first thing you need to do is log into your Rev virtual machine, and I'll show you some of the things that you'll need as prerequisites for this installation. I'm going to log in as admin in the internal profile, and you'll see by my dashboard there are several things that are pre-configured for this installation. So the first thing I did was to get a host pre-configured, in this case RevH, known as revh.lab.example.com for the host name. I've configured it as a host for Rev so that I can launch virtual machines within that host. I also have a data center that allows me to have storage and export domains. And if you notice in the storage tab, I have a data domain and an export domain. Called data for the data domain and export for the export domain. I also need some networks for my virtual machine, or at least one network. In this case, I've configured a single network that allows me to manage the virtual machine so I can assign an IP address to this virtual machine so I can then configure it and it can manage various machines outside of the network. All right, so my next step is to show you how to download the CloudForms virtual appliance. First thing you'll need to do is log in to access.redhat.com. Once you've logged in to access.redhat.com, you'll go down to the quick links down at the bottom of the page and click on Downloads. Scroll down to the Cloud Products, and you'll find Red Hat CloudForms. In the link that is provided for Red Hat CloudForms, you'll see a number of virtual machines that are available for the CloudForms appliance. You only need one, and in this case, we'll download the RevM virtual appliance. So here I see the Red Hat virtual appliance. I'll click on Download Now and download the file. Now that I've got the virtual appliance downloaded, I'll go ahead and log into my RevM machine to import it as a template. So I'll log in as root, and then I'll use the engine image uploader to upload the image into Rev. So my user is admin at internal. The engine name is revm.lab.example.com, port 443. And because we're using SSL, we need to include the certificate. So cert file is /etc/pki/overt/engine/ca.pem. Then we need to tell it the export domain. In my case, it's called export to keep it simple. And then we tell it the command, which is upload in this case. And we give it the name of the file. And in the case of Rev, that will be an OVA file. So remember to download it from access.redhat.com. Then it will ask me for the password for the admin user. And eventually, after a couple of minutes, it will upload that image into RevM. Now that the image upload has completed, we'll go through the steps to import the image as a template into Rev. We'll use the overt shell command to perform several of these next few steps, so you can follow along. Overt shell -E. In this case, we want to list out the templates. And we'll get specific here, so we list out the storage domain name as well. So the parent storage domain name is export. Now I do this so that I can find the ID of that image that we just imported. And now I can import the image as a template. So we'll use overt shell again to import it. This time we'll tell it the action is for templates. I'll use the template ID that I found above and really this is the ID of the image that I've got to import for the template. And again, I want to tell it which export domain it's in. So again, dash dash parent storage domain name is export. Also tell it the name of the data storage domain. So we've called it data, so I'll use that. And I need to tell it the name of the cluster. In my case, it's RHT underscore cluster. And we'll tell it to use the asynchronous transfer, so it will run in the background. And we'll tell it the name of the template, which is the name that I see here in my original output. So I'll copy and paste that. And finally, import underscore template. So this command will allow you to take that image that we just uploaded and convert it into a template that we can then use as a virtual machine. And now we'll take a look at the template to make sure it's complete. So I'll use overt shell again. Show template and pass it the ID that I used before. And you should see the status state go from locked to up or OK. And you should see the status state go from locked to OK. And you notice now I see the status state is OK, so I am free to proceed. Now we'll create a virtual machine. So we'll use overt shell, add VM. We'll give it a name, and this time we'll just call it CloudForms to keep it simple. Cluster name is RHT underscore cluster. Make sure that the console is enabled so we can do some initial configuration for CloudForms. And I'll go back and find the template ID that we've used previously. I'll copy and paste that into my command, finish it off with a quote, and that should start the process of creating a virtual machine. The next thing I need to do is add a network card to this virtual machine. I've previously configured networking in Rev, but I need to add a NIC to the virtual machine. So I'll go through the steps of adding that virtual machine now. So add NIC is the command I need. Parent VM name is the name of the virtual machine, CloudForms again. I need to include the name of the network. In my case, it's RevM. And the name of the NIC. In this case, NIC1. And finally, I'll add the MAC address. In class, we have specific MAC addresses that translate into IP addresses using our DHCP server. So in this case, we'll use a 52:54:00:00:FA:14 as the MAC address that we'll use for this virtual machine, and then it will translate into an IP address and also into a DNS name that we'll use for class. And finally, I need to make sure that the virtual machine is actually up and ready. So I'll run another overt command, show VM CloudForms. And the status state should go from down to, and the status state should actually go from image locked to the down state. And then you'll know that the virtual machine is ready to be launched. You can also add an extra disk if you want to CloudForms, if you need some more disk space. In this case, we don't need to, so I'll skip that part. And then we'll jump right into actually launching the virtual machine. So let's launch the virtual machine. So ActionVM, CloudForms, start. And that will launch the virtual machine. Now it takes a few seconds for it to actually launch the virtual machine in rev. We'll wait for a few seconds, make sure it's running, and then we'll attempt to SSH into the virtual machine to make sure that it's actually available. Now let's go ahead and log into the virtual machine that I have for CloudForms. SSH root at 172.25.250.20. I'll accept the host key. The password should be SmartVM. And you'll notice it says welcome to the appliance console, and it tells me to run the appliance underscore console command in order to do the initial configuration. You'll see that in class, and you will actually do the initial configuration there. So we've just seen the import of the CloudForms appliance into Rev. I've logged in and I'm ready now for the initial configuration of CloudForms. This is part of the CL220 CloudForms Hybrid Cloud Management course. Good luck with the class.